Masterclass Yoga Live with Tiffany Danz.
Welcome everybody, I'm Tiffany and we're gonna do a vinyasa flow today. Vinyasa roughly translates to breath with movement. So it's kind of like a moving meditation. We will do mostly mid-level poses, but today I have Chelsea Jones joining us. She will be doing modifications and she'll also be participating in the yoga class. So if for whatever reason I start talking and I'm not moving, you can always look to her to see what's going on. If at any time you feel any pain, tingling, or discomfort in a pose, I'd like to ask you to come out of that pose and either try a modification or go to child's pose, which is what we'll start off with today. Also, Ms. Jones and I do live in homes with pets and small children, so don't be surprised if you see any special guests running around. All right, so we are going to start in a child's pose today. You'll bring your toes together, knees wide, and then fold forward on your mat and rest your belly between your knees. You can try to touch your forehead to the ground and then just stretch your hands out in front of you and start to establish a regular breathing pattern, breathing in through the nose and out through the nose. So let's just breathe here for a few moments. Inhale and exhale. Inhale. Exhale. One more deep breath in. And out. On your next inhale, gently walk your hands to the right side of your mat, giving yourself a nice, gentle stretch in your left side body. And continue to breathe. Throughout your yoga practice, whenever your mind starts to wander, I'd like you to come back to your breath. On your next inhale, gently move your hands back to the center and all the way over to the left side of your mat, giving yourself that stretch in your right side body. With each inhale and exhale, sink a little closer to the mat. And then come back to center and come to your hands and knees in a box pose. Hands below elbows, elbows below shoulders. Knees should be about hip width apart. And just establish this neutral spine. Tuck your belly in so your core is activated. Having a strong core will protect your lower back, your knees, and your neck. So take a deep breath in. And on your exhale, drop your belly, lift your head, and look forward for cow pose. Inhale to an angry cat. Exhale, cow. Inhale, cat. And continue to inhale to your cow and cat in your own time. Adding any movements you think may be helpful, you can circle your hips, sway back and forth, or just continue these motions. And then come back to a neutral spine. Inhale your right hand forward, your left foot back. Flex your feet towards the wall. And you should feel your whole body activated here. This is a full body pose. Your core is strong and you feel energy from the tips of your fingers to the tips of your toes. So reach forward while reaching back. Take a deep breath in and exhale, bring everything into your chest. Inhale, reach out. Exhale, pull in. Inhale. And come back to your box pose. Inhale, left hand forward, right foot back. Establish that strong pose. Feel that Pull with your opposing reach forward and back. Take a deep breath in. Exhale, pull everything into your chest. Inhale out. Exhale in. Inhale out. And exhale in. And meet you back in your box pose. We're now going to find our first downward facing dog. So tuck your toes and then lift your hips up, pushing your heels back. If you need to bend your knees, please feel free to do so. Otherwise, try to reach your heels towards the floor. If they don't touch, that's absolutely fine. Shake your head yes, shake it no. Just release all the tension in your neck. You should feel this in your shoulders, your hamstrings. This is a full body pose, but try not to have too much pressure on your hands and wrists by really pushing back into those hips. Take a deep breath in. And exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale up on your tippy toes. Then exhale, push your heels back down. And on your next inhale, step or jump your feet between your hands. Forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, lift all the way up, high mountain pose. I'm gonna turn and face you. Really activate all the way from your feet to your hands. Feel the balls of your feet like suction cups on the floor. Your legs should be about hip width distance apart. Relax your shoulders and breathe. Bring your hands together. Inhale, reach to your right. Back to center, to the left, back to center. Give yourself a small back bend, back to center, and then fold forward. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, lift all the way up. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, lift halfway, and then step or jump to plank. This is a good chance to look at Miss Jones and see what modifiers she does here. We're gonna do a chaturanga. So if you're not familiar with yoga, it's kind of like a push-up, but you keep your elbows tucked in. You can lower to your knees like Miss Jones, or you can stay in plank position like me. Push yourself forward, lower halfway. Don't let your elbows go past your ribs. Inhale, up dog. And exhale, down dog. Take a deep breath here. We're gonna do one more of those. It's called a sun salutation. And it's just waking us up, preparing us for the rest of our yoga practice. Deep breath in. Exhale, step or jump to the front of your mat. Inhale, halfway lift, flat back. Exhale, fold. Inhale, lift all the way up. Exhale, forward fold. These are good inversions, so they send a lot of oxygen to your blood or to your brain. Help you wake up a little bit. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, step or jump to plank. Deep breath in, push yourself forward on your toes or lower to your knees. Chaturanga. Up dog and down dog. Lift your right leg up, three-legged dog. And then bring your right foot between your hands and lift up, crescent lunge. We're now in the warrior sequence of our vinyasa practice. So we are gonna be moving a little bit more, but still fairly gentle. But if you ever need to modify, just take a look at Miss Jones. Bring your hands to your heart and then gently twist to your right over your right knee, keeping a 90 degree angle. Don't let your knees go past your ankle or your toes. And back to center. Drop the back foot, warrior one. Take a deep breath in. Make sure your core is strong. Tuck your tailbone in. Push into your left, the side of your left foot so you don't have so much pressure on the inside of your foot. And then really sink down into that right knee. And open up to warrior two. Deep breath in. Reverse your warrior. Feel that stretch in your right side body. And exhale, side angle. Come back up, warrior two. And windmill your arms. Back to down dog. We're gonna take three cleansing breaths here. Inhale. Deep breath in. Exhale. One more deep breath in. And exhale. Left foot, three-legged dog. Bring that left foot between your hands. Establish the strength here. And then rise, crescent lunge. If you need to put your back knee on the ground, that's fine. It's still just as strong. Takes a little bit of pressure off your back leg. Bring your hands to heart center and twist over your left knee. Drop the back foot, warrior one. Open up, warrior two. Inhale, reverse your warrior. Exhale, side angle. You can rest your elbow on your knee, or if you want a little bit more, you can reach forward. Back to warrior two. Windmill the arms. Downward facing dog. Take a deep breath in. And exhale. This is a great flow to do anytime you need to take a break from studying, or you've been watching too many shows on Netflix in one sitting and you just need to get your lymphatic system moving. Inhale, right leg up, three-legged dog. Exhale, bring your foot between your hands. And we're going straight to warrior two. So turn out your back foot. Your hips and your torso should be facing forward. And just hold here for a moment. Tuck your tailbone in, activate your core, and really sink into that front leg. Now, ground in, ground down through your right foot. We're gonna do our first balance pose. So I want you to suction cup your feet to the ground. Take a deep breath in. Exhale. On your inhale, reach forward. Flex the back foot towards the ground. Warrior three. You can keep your hands in front of you or bring them to heart center. Whatever feels most comfortable for you. One more breath in. Exhale to warrior two. Inhale, reverse. Exhale, side angle. And breathe. Inhale, back to warrior two. Windmill the arms, and I'll meet you in down dog. Left leg, three-legged dog. Bring the left foot between your hands. Twist the back right foot and lift to warrior one. Establish that strength. Ground through the left foot. And on your next inhale, push yourself forward. Warrior three. Keep the back foot flexed towards the ground. And try to find a focal point to focus on, your drishti. The drishti helps us see with neutral vision. So we're blurring out the world around us and seeing without judgment. Drop the back foot, warrior two. Inhale, reverse your warrior. Exhale, side angle. Inhale, back to warrior two. Exhale, meet me in down dog. We're gonna take three cleansing breaths. Deep breath in. This time, exhale through the mouth, let everything out. Deep breath in. And exhale. Right foot forward, straight to warrior two. Look down across your right fingers. Sink into your right foot. And then gently straighten the right leg. Try not to lock the knee. You still want to protect it. Just a micro bend in the knee. Reach forward as far as you can. And then reach up, triangle pose. Don't worry about touching the ground or anything like that. You can reach for your ankle, your calf. The main goal of this pose is to really open up the chest, give us a break from hunching over our computers all day. You can look up, or if that's too much, look forward or down, and breathe. With each exhale, you can reach a little further. Don't push it. Find that sweet spot right between not enough and too much. Inhale up. Turn your left foot in. You can walk it closer to your right foot, kind of like you're on a railroad track. As close as you need to be comfortable. And then we're gonna fold forward again. Slip pyramid pose. Try to push back with your right hip. Push your right hip back. Left hip slightly forward. Breathe here. You can twist your left arm up to the sky. If that's too much for you, just stay here in this triangle pose. Release your neck. Relax your shoulders. And gently come up. Legs a little more than hip distance apart, maybe as wide as you can get them safely. I'm going to do a wide leg forward fold. Reach up to the sky, relax your shoulders, and then gently fold forward. This is another mild inversion. Anything that gets your head below your heart is considered an inversion. And like I said, it just brings a lot of blood flow to your brain, gives you a little bit more energy. It's like an instant wake-up call. So fold forward. Shake the head yes, shake it no. We'll just hang here for a minute. Breathing in. And out. You can reach your right hand to the sky. Or if that's too much, just stay in your forward fold. Bring the right hand down and reach the left hand up. Now slowly, vertebrae by vertebrae, inhale your body up. Your head should be the last thing up. And we're gonna turn to the left for that triangle pose again. So right foot should be pointing towards this wall, just like we would in our warrior. Left foot this way, arms out, and then reach as far as you can before you fold that triangle pose. Again, as much space as you can get between your shoulders to really open up that chest is so important. We spend all day just hunched over and it's not very good for our spine. So this helps counteract some of that damage we do all day long. Breathe here. When you're ready, slowly come up and walk your right foot behind your left on that train track. Push back with both hips and fold forward, triangle pose or pyramid. And breathe. You can twist this or just stay where you are. And back down. Come back to center. We're gonna bring our hips more than hips distance apart again. This time we're gonna turn our toes out and squat. This is called a goddess pose. So you can bring your hands to heart center. Sink as low as you can. If you're right here, you're right here. If you're down here, that's great too. Just breathe. We're opening our hips a little bit, taking some pressure off of our low backs. I want you to lift your right foot up on your tiptoes and then drop the heel down. Left heel up, getting a good ankle stretch and heel back down. Can you do both heels? Some balance. And exhale, drop both heels down. Give yourself a little twist. And the other way. And then stand up in your mountain pose. Nice, strong, steady, activated. Tuck your core in. We're gonna do some balance poses. So really root down into the earth. Close your eyes. Establish that strength for a minute. Feel the energy through your fingers, through your toes. And then really ground through your right foot. Suction cup to the floor. Hands to heart center. Tree pose. You can use your hand to guide you. You can either place your foot on the inner thigh, the calf, or the ankle. Or you can keep your toe on the ground. Whatever is comfortable for you. We're going to breathe here for a few moments. It's okay to wobble. I do it all the time. Again, find that focal point, that drishti, to help you establish a neutral vision. And breathe. If this is not enough of a challenge for you, you can try to close your eyes, see if that changes things up a little bit. And really feel the strength in that core. Lift your hands up. Exhale back to heart center and bring your left foot down. Switch sides, really ground through that left foot. Bring your right foot to your inner thigh, calf, or ankle. And breathe. Reach up, stand tall. Hands back to heart center and let that go. We're gonna bring our right knee into our chest. Flex the foot, give yourself a little hug. If you're modifying, I'd like you to stay here and find the balance and the strength in this pose. If not, you can open the knee, open the arms. You can even grab your toe and stretch. Or you can just stay here or here and breathe. Let that go. Ground your left foot. Yes, ground through the right foot. Flex your left foot, hug the knee. Whatever you did on the last side, you should repeat on this side. So if you opened, or if you did a little stretch, do so on this side as well, but careful not to collapse your shoulders too much. You still want to stand up straight and tall. And breathe. Let that go. Come to the top of your mat. And then meet me in a chair pose. Activate your core. Sink down as far as you can into that seated position. Arms can reach above you, or they can come to heart center. And breathe. Deep breath in. Exhale, sink a little lower. Inhale. Exhale, sink a little lower. One more deep breath in. Exhale, lower. And forward fold. Catch your breath. Shake your head yes. Shake it no. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, lift all the way up. Mountain pose. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, jump to plank or modify on your knees. Deep breath in. Exhale, chaturanga. Up dog and down dog. All right, friends, the hardest part is done. Now it's mostly stretching, but I will make you do one more core exercise because your core is the most important part of yoga and maybe even life. I don't know. All right, right foot up. Bring your right knee to your right wrist. Pigeon pose. This is a great hip opener. You can relax your leg down. And if this is enough for you, stay here. If you want a little bit more, you can walk your hands forward, fold over that right knee. And just breathe here for a few moments. If you feel any tingling in this pose or pain, come out of it and go to your child's pose. Otherwise, just breathe here. This is a great hip opener. We hold a lot of tension in our hips and our shoulders and our jaw. So pigeon pose really helps open up our hips. So breathe here. If you've folded forward, gently walk yourself up. Push back to down dog. Left leg up. And bring your left knee to your left elbow, pigeon other side. Again, you can stay here or you can fold forward, but whatever you did on the last side, I recommend also doing on this side just to keep things even. And breathe. Inhale back up and down dog. Punch your plank. Lower all the way to your belly. All over on your back. This is our last big core exercise for today. Just want to make sure you have a really strong core. Support yourself always. So reach your feet up, 90 degree angle. If this is enough for you, stay here. Otherwise, you can lift your shoulders, lift your hands, and then gently start dropping your legs inch by inch. Slowly, slowly, keep going. Hold here, and release. Give yourself a huge good morning stretch. Reach your hands above you, feet in front of you. Shake out any tension you have here. And then bring your knees up, bend them, feet on the ground. I want you to bring your right knee into your chest. And then cross your right ankle over your left knee. This is a four legged stretch. Grab your left thigh and then gently pull your left thigh towards your body. You can push your right knee out with your elbow, or you can just grab your knee and pull. This is another good hip opener. Release a lot of tension in our hips and our lower back, help reset our spine. Try to keep your feet flexed just to give you a little extra stretch. Our spine can move in 7 different directions. So when you're doing a yoga class or doing yoga at home in between your study breaks or after dinner with your family, you try to move your spine in 7 different directions. You go back through, you might be able to find all the ways you move today. And then gently come out of the pose, switch sides, left ankle over right knee. Reach through and grab that right thigh. You can push your left knee with your left elbow if you'd like. Remember to keep your feet flexed. And just breathe. At this point, you can close your eyes, relax your jaw, start to wind down. But remember to continue to breathe. If there are distractions in your home, pets, kids, siblings, just come back to your breath and focus on this moment and the good that you're doing for your body. Bring both feet back to the mat. And then I want you to bring your arms out to a T pose, palms facing up. Bring your knees into your chest. And then let them fall to the right side as you look to the left. This is a supine twist. You're feeling the twist in your body. And breathe. Make sure to look over to your left side. If that's too much for you, then just look straight up at the sky, or you can look to the side you're twisting. Inhale back to center. And exhale, drop your knees to the other side. Look to the right. Inhale, center. All right, inhale back to center. Drop your feet to the ground and then open your legs as if you are in a reclined butterfly position. Arms can remain at a T. And just look up, close your eyes, and breathe. This is called a Supta Baddha Konasana. And I feel like it is the ultimate spine reset when it comes to hip openers. Super comfortable. Close your eyes, relax your jaw, and when you're ready, reach your feet long. You can bring your hands beside you. Keep your eyes closed. This is your Shavasana. It's the last part of a yoga class, and it's a time to reflect and to just come back to your breath and thank your body for all of the work that it's done today. As you continue to breathe in this pose, I'm going to read you an excerpt from one of my favorite poems. I feel like it's very fitting for right now, and it's something that I come back to anytime my world feels a little bit shaky. It's called The Desiderata. So as you breathe and reflect, just listen to these words, and hopefully they can impact you in a way that is helpful. Go placidly amid the noise and haste, and remember what peace there may be in silence. As far as possible, without surrender, be on good terms with all persons. Speak your truth quietly and clearly, and listen to others. Even the dull and the ignorant, they too have their story. Avoid loud and aggressive persons. They are vexations to the spirit. If you compare yourself with others, you may become vain and bitter, for always there will be greater and lesser persons than yourself. Enjoy your achievements as well as your plans. The world is full of trickery, but let this not blind you to what virtue there is. Life is full of heroism. Be yourself. Especially do not feign affection. Neither be cynical about love, for in the face of all aridity and disenchantment, it is as perennial as the grass. Beyond a wholesome discipline, be gentle with yourself. You are a child of the universe. No less than the trees and the stars, you have a right to be here. And whether or not it is clear to you, no doubt the universe is unfolding as it should. Therefore, be at peace with God, whatever you perceive him to be. And whatever your labors and aspirations in this noisy confusion of life, keep peace with your soul. With all its sham, drudgery, and broken dreams, it is still a beautiful world. Be cheerful. Strive to be happy. Come back to your breath one more time. Wiggle your fingers. Wiggle your toes. And with your eyes still closed, when you're ready, roll onto your favorite side and slowly come up to a seated position. Keeping the eyes closed, bring your hands to heart center. The light in me honors the light in you. Namaste. Thank you for joining me today. I hope you learned something new, and I hope you're able to come back and look at this anytime you need a quick study break or need to release a little bit of tension. If you have any questions, as always, you can reach out to me. Thank you, Mrs. Jones, for joining us today. And I hope you all have a great Thursday.